Lynn, one of the main arguments the environmentalists use is that, quote, the gene pool must be preserved because it provides for the development of medicines and other useful things for humanity. Now, I think the gene pool they refer to is the collective genetic information contained within a population of organisms, rather than my own family, of course, which has consisted almost exclusively of genes until recently. My father, my uncle, my cousin, myself were all genes. But I think that there is an inherent fallacy in this that I'd like you, my own family aside, that I'd like you to address. But then a question from someone here in the audience who obviously doesn't hate humanity, and whose question actually is reflected by at least half a dozen other questions that have come in. And that question is, Lynn, I'm truly puzzled as to why you see solar and wind energy as harmful. I want to understand this, and what I can't understand is why it is that something that doesn't pollute the environment is wrong to use. And a number of people have written in saying, look, I'm pro-nuclear, but, you know, why not use this as long as we have it available to us? Why do you see it as such a problem?
Because the windmills and solar collectors are pollution. It's a fact. The standard of proof of cleanliness is energy flux density. And the incremental rate of energy flux density, which is produced by certain kinds of technology and scientific progress. The problem is those who say there's pollution. There is no pollution in that nuclear power, any more than there is in anything else. The worst pollution is the lack of nuclear power, because the ability of the human species to exist now depends absolutely on nuclear power. If you're against nuclear power, you're against humanity, because humanity now depends upon it. The greatest pollution is the pollution of ideas with that kind of character, because those kinds of ideas determine your behavior. Your choices determine your behavior. Your behavior is either beneficial for the human species or it's not. If it's not beneficial for the human species or is used as a substitute for which is beneficial, that is pollution. You choose to define pollution in the wrong terms. You're giving it a very restricted meaning, which it does not regulate. Excess windmills are pollution. They are inherently pollution. The birds will tell you that immediately. And they may come down in great numbers and unleash their bowels upon you to let you know about that. I wouldn't blame them if they did it. It probably would help fertilize the territory at the same time as, you know, these kinds of things. Now, this is the point. It is pollution. It's a scientific question. There are not things of what I like and what I feel, or what I don't like and what I don't want to feel. That's not the standard of anything. That's nonsense. It's pure gibberish. Lack of critical judgment. Our job is to maintain the human species and the functions I said earlier this evening as the immortal species, mankind, or a mortal species, among others we may discover of mankind. Anything that worsens the conditions of life and progress for mankind in that direction is pollution. The President of the United States is a pollution. Because he's destructive. And the thing lies that is in a process of developing a nation. Look what's happening. Look what the pollution is. These windmills are killing people. Is that pollution? Look at these damn things up there. They're pollution. Look at the energy flux density of a windmill. Look at the cost it is to build it, to maintain it. It's pollution, pure pollution. But solar collectors are pure pollution by any rational standpoint. They either substitute something which is rotten, inefficient, and actually criminal in effect, the solar collectors. Pollution. Pollution is as pollution does. That's your standard. Not whether you like it or not. You want to kiss it, or you want to do something else to it. Who knows what? You want to sodomize it? I don't know. But that's the point. That which is not useful for humanity is questionable. It's pollution. That which causes a deterioration of the spread of the standard of living of humanity is pollution. Something can be pollution for what it does not do as much as what it does. You cannot pick one. You cannot pick and choose and set a standard which you pick and choose because you want to prefer something. It's sophistry. And the argument that I heard in terms of pollution is a clear case of the use of sophistry to make something sound pretty when it stinks.